All right, let's do some questions on cost, volume, profit, or break-even analysis. It says at the break-even point, the contribution margin equals, at break-even, let's come over here, sales minus variable cost is contribution minus fixed profit. At break-even, that means this number has to equal this number. That means contribution margin equals what?
Your fixed cost.
Okay. Variable cost, sales revenue, as sellers, a fixed cost, D. Number 12, break-even analysis assumes that over the relevant range, unit revenues are nonlinear. No. In other words, most things are linear. Unit variable costs are unchanged. True. Remember, we have within the relevant range, fixed or fixed in total, variable or fixed per unit. Total costs are unchanged. No. Total fixed costs are nonlinear. No, they're linear. In other words, fixed costs are a line. Linear is a line. They're going straight out, fixed. Variable costs are pretty much a line at an angle, but a slope. What's the best answer? Unit variable costs are unchanged. Yes, the unit per hour, because we're within the relevant range. We're fixed or fixed, variable or fixed per unit. 13. Delco has fixed costs of 100 and break-even sales of 800. What is the projected profit of 1,000,002 in sales? All right, so now we've got to come up with our, let's kind of see here. They're saying fixed costs are 100, break-even is 800. So that means break-even sales is 800. So what we need to do is come up with our what? Our CM ratio. So if we come up with our CM ratio, then what we can do is use that, plug it in to figure out how many sales. What does it say? It says, what is the projected profit at 1,000,002? So we got to figure out what our profit is. All right. So this one's a little tricky. It looks like it's using this formula. So let's clean this up a little bit and start there. Let's start with what we know and what they've told us. All right. So what do we know so far? We know that break-even in sales dollars, 800, equals fixed cost over something, a CM ratio. So what that tells us is 1 over something is 800, or if we multiply this by CM ratio, that goes here, divide this by 800, that goes here. So CM ratio is 1 over 8, which equals something like 0.125, 12.5%. Okay, so now if we were to say break even in sales, but we want to have a profit, and what it says is, what is the profit at 1,000,002 in sales? 1,000,002 in sales. All right. Well, we know that we have fixed costs of 100. So let's set this up. We're going to have fixed costs of 100. We have a CM ratio that we just figured out is 0.125. And we know that break even in sales dollars, well, it's not break even. It's going to be at 1,000,002 equals 100 plus X profit over 0.125. Huh? Let's see what we did. Up here, they gave us this. They said break even at 100 fixed is 800,000 sales. That gives us this is what? 0.125. The CM ratio is not changing. So for this formula, CM ratio 0.125, good to know. They told us at 1,000,002, you're going to have this plus profit. What is our profit at 1,000,002? Well, we're going to end up with solving for X is we end up with 150 equals 100 plus X. Subtract that over, 50 equals X. So they're saying, what is the profit? Taking this, multiply each side times 0.125, boom, multiply this times 0.125, which I don't have a calculator on me. That is going to equal 100 plus X. So, oh, I guess that must equal 150. There we go. That's gone. So 150 equals 100 plus X, minus 100, minus 100, X equals 50. And if you plug it in, 100 plus 50 divided by 0.125 should equal 1,000,002.